President Yoweri Museveni today condoled with Ugandans, paying tribute to the late minister, Colonel Charles Okello Engola. He described Engola as a lion for his courage in battling and defeating the LRA in his area of command. The president expounded on the praise name Majuduogo given to the late Engola by Ugandans who were being terrorized by the LRA rebels. He said due to Engola's courage, people managed to return home and continue to comfortably light fires to cook without fear of being attacked. The president said due to Engola's popularity, he was elected LC5 chairperson and eventually member of parliament. The president said investigations into the death of the late Engola would help security rectify certain gaps in VIP protection. Meanwhile, it is a somber mood at the home of slain Minister of State for Labour, Charles Engola, who was shot dead yesterday by his new bodyguard, Wilson Sabiti, at his home in Chanja. As funeral arrangements are underway, we managed to talk to Sam Odon, the driver of the late Minister Charles Engola. Odon recounts the last moments and how the shooting unfolded.
Muzee, I heard his voice coming. He came. This man saluted him. He opened the door. They interact. He said, hey, today I'm going with you. What is your name? This man told Muzee his name. Muzee entered, he closed.
According to him, it was 8 a.m. in the morning when Minister Engola left his house to his waiting vehicle where his aide, Lieutenant Ronald Otim, and another guard identified as Senyonga were waiting. After talking to them briefly, the minister boarded the vehicle. All this while, Odon says Private Wilson Sabiti was sitting at the gate and they thought he was waiting to open it for the minister's vehicle to exit. However, they were shocked when he shot at Lieutenant Ronald Otim, who was opening the flags on the vehicle.
The moment this man is going to the front to remove the cover of the flag, Lizzy Sabit Kumbe, I don't know what he was already thinking. I was not knowing because I'm already in the car waiting to move. ADC wake up, begin coming to Muze. Before we reach to Muze, in front of the vehicle, I just heard the bullet. This bullet goes to ADC. I just saw ADC down in front of the vehicle. More bullet passed behind me through the window, enter to Muze inside. Then one bullet passed under my chair from the door where I sit. So for me, I was just covering my head like this.
After shooting Otim, the driver says he took cover while the minister immediately got out of the vehicle to also try and take cover. Unfortunately, he fell to the ground while Sabiti continued to shoot at him.
Muze tried to open the door and he fell down. I'm already inside. I cannot open because this man is there shooting bullet. For Muze, he heard a lot. I saw him by turning my eyes slowly. I saw him because the door was open. But he ordered me to disappear within seconds. Then he fired bullet up. About twice.
Odon narrates that during the shooting, the minister pleaded with Sabiti not to kill him. After witnessing the horrific shooting of the minister, he ran out of the gate and hid. While in hiding, Odon narrates that he could hear Sabiti's lamentations as he shot in the air. After hearing news that Sabiti had also shot himself, he rushed back to the house where he found his boss lying in a pool of blood.
After this man, I heard people saying this man killed himself. I came back home, I found my door is open, but the bullet has already passed there. But it has not injured me.
You didn't check yourself after seeing
it? I tried to check, I thought there's blood, because I saw the point where the bullet entered. I began touching myself, I found I'm safe.
Mourners continue to throng the minister's home where funeral arrangements are underway. Currently, the family awaits an official communication on burial arrangements from the government. The body of the late Charles Engola is still at the city mortuary, while the wounded aide is still undergoing treatment at Mulago National Referral Hospital. Report by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.